Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan. My name is Patrick Saul, and I'm the East Asia correspondent for the Swiss newspaper Neue Zürcher Zeitung. Our guest today is Ms. Rebiya Kadeer. She's a pretty regular guest here at the FCCJ, actually. And as you all know, she's the president of the World Uyghur Congress. She's here to explain, mainly to Japanese politicians, but also Japanese media, the situation of the Uyghur people. And that's what she's going to do here first. She's going to give a short introduction about the current situation, and then we'll open up for questions and answers. Before I forget, please turn off your mobile phones or put them on manner mode so they don't disturb us. Ms. Rebiya Kadeer, please.
Hamminglarning tushdan keyingi xayrlik bo'lsin. Rahmat kaginlarga va qulubtiklarni o'rlashtirganiga.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for coming. So I would like to thank the Foreign Correspondent Club for organizing this press conference.
Bu qitim biz Yaponiyaga xalqimizning vaziyati intayin ig'ir bo'lishqa biz Amerikada va Yevropada dunyoning hamma yerida o'zimizning ahvolimizni degan bo'lsakmi, ya'ni Yaponiyagimi mushundaq jiddiy bir vaziyat haqida Yaponiya hukumatiga va xalq jurnalistlarga bir uqtirish to'g'riliq bo'yakan.
So the purpose of our trip to Japan this time is to inform and in brief the Japanese politicians, Japanese journalists, reporters in public about the Chinese government's ongoing crackdown in East Turkestan and intensified repression on Uyghur people.
Onun üstüge Xitay hükümeti Şarkı Türkistan'ın Besvağan'ın 66 yıllığı hem Şincan Uyghur atalmış Şincan Uyghur Abdunum Rayın degen kanunlu belgenge 60 yıllığını bu yıl bütün dünyaya Uyghurların en bəxtli kıldık deyip tenten bile ilan kıldı.
As you know, Chinese government on the 1st of October celebrated the 66th anniversary of the communist takeover of the East Turkestan and the 60th anniversary of Xinjiang establishment of the Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region and claimed that they brought prosperity, equality for the Uyghur people.
Дәл Хытай үкіметі дүния ұйғырларының бәқті қылдық деп илан қуатқан мұш пәйттің өзі де мұңлачы, он мұңлачы әдем яш ұйғырлар Хытайның тұрмыста. Yüzlerce, onlarca Uygurlar her günü, her hafta dediği dek itip öldürülüyorken Şarkı Türkistan'ın işçi de şunda ihir bir pacaya devirdi.
So in contrast to Chinese government's claim that they brought the prosperity and luck for the Uyghur people, the situation in East Turkestan is getting worse and thousands of the Uyghur political prisoners are lingering and suffering in Chinese prison. And on the extrajudicial killings of the Uyghur people by the Chinese security forces is continued.
Mana dal mushundaq vaqtida tarixda misli ko'rilmagan g'odis xarakterlik 10 minglarcha Uyghurlar iqib ballarini 4-5 ballarini so'rab butun uy makonlarini yerlarini tashlab dunyoning hamma yeriga sargandar bo'lib qochib chiqqan vaqt edi.
And also thousands of Uyghurs are escaping from the Chinese persecution, trying to take refuge in neighboring countries with their children and leaving all their belongings and only to save their lives.
Agar Xitoy hukumatı Uyghurlarni o'zi degandek 60 yil ichida ajoyib baxtli xotirjam turmushga erishdigan bo'lsa, Sharqi Turkistonning yerlik millati bo'lgan Uyghur xalqi nima uchun bundoq turmularga to'shib ketdi? Nima uchun bundoq dunyoga sargandar bo'lib chiqib ketdi? Nima uchun undoq o'lim vaqalari, qonliq vaqalari ko'p yuz berdi degan savol butun dunyodami bo'lish kerak deb qarayman.
So we are so if the Chinese government what the Chinese government, of course, claimed that they brought prosperity and equality for the Uyghur people, development for the region, if they are right in their claim, and why, and then all these bloody incidents are happening in East Turkestan, why thousands of people are leaving East Turkestan as refugees and taking refuge in neighboring countries, and why thousands of Uyghur political prisoners are suffering in Chinese prisons.
Менин Японияга кеттин чыктым келишим, ар кытым келген вактыда уйгурлардын миллий кимлиги ва уйгурлардын кишилик укугу, уйгурлардын иктисадий маселеси, тил маселеси, кызлар маселеси хакында декалат берген эдим.
So this is the seventh time I'm visiting Japan. So in my past visits, I talked about the Chinese government's human rights violation, economic backwardness of the Uyghur people, and they are about the difficulty to use their language and religious repression, and about these things.
Lekin bu qitim Uyghurlarning hayot mamat masalasi, Uyghurlarning keng ko'lamda qirg'inchilik qilish masalasi ustida dakolat berdim.
So now I would like to talk about the death and life situation in East Turkestan.
Uyghurlar bugun har hafta digidek, har kun digidek Xitoy hukumati Xi Jinping chiqqan mush 2 yil ichida Uyghurlarni o'lim jazosiga hukm qilishni mayli Xujuntov bo'lsin, mayli Jang Zemin bo'lsin, qandoq rais bo'lsin Uyghurlarni yolg'ondim bo'lsin, rostim bo'lsin tutib bir sot qilib o'lim jazosiga hukm qilatdi. Lekin Xi Jinping chiqqan bu 2 yil ichida Uyghurlarga hech qanday sot qilish emas, o'ylarni xoliga yada xalq saqchilari tomonidan etib o'ltirish huquqi tovangi tushdi.
So during the Xi Jinping's rule, the repression in East Turkestan, the situation in East Turkestan deteriorated dramatically and repression intensified. Of course, during the Jiang Zemin and Hu Jintao era, there was also the repression, there was repression. But at least, for example, the Uyghur dissidents arrested, and the people who resisted the Chinese security forces arrested, and there was some show trials, and then persecuted, and then sentenced to prison or executed. But now the new phenomena is the extrajudicial killings. Now Chinese security forces, in a very small sign of resistance, shoot and kill the Uyghur people. This is the new phenomena in East Turkestan.
Bu siyaset Uyghurlarga zorlab çekiliş, Uyghurlarni öç ilişki mecburlaş, Uyghurlarni muşundak nait kattık bir özgü karşı çıkışkı zorlaştığını ibaret siyaset deyip karıdık.
This repression, of course, this say, of course, this repression also they have a reaction by the Uyghurs, and because of this repression of the Chinese government, the situation is becoming worse and tensions are rising among the Chinese and Uyghur people.
Men jiq vaqtinglarni olmaslik uchun faqat Sharq Turkistonda bo'layotgan qirg'inchilikning bir nili misol qilib beraman. Bunda qirg'inchiliklar har haftada, har 10 kunda bir yuz beryapti. Azaldan Uyghurlarga o'lim jazosi hukm qilish nisbati Xitoy davlati bo'yicha aytganda siyosiy mahbuslarga faqat Uyghurlarga o'lim jazosi berish eng yuqori bosqichda. Mana mushundaq paytda men hozir qonunsiz o'ltirishdan bir nili misol qilib gapiraman.
So I would like to just give an example about the bloody incidents which happening in East Turkestan. And I would like also stress that the Chinese government only execute Uyghur political prisoners. No other ethnic groups are executed because of the political reasons.
Uyghurlar yakanda Ramazanning 27-chi kuni Мушу 2014 жылы 7 айның 14-ті бір ақшам әммісі намаз оқышқа мешкіті шығып кетеді. Аялла 2-3 өйдікі аялла балла бір өйге кіріп, ибадат қуатқан вақытта Қытай сақшылары тәрібіден кіріп, төвіні 3 яшлық бала, юқұрышысы 70 яшлық аяллығыча қырып етіп шығып кетеді.
So I would like to give the example of the Yarkand incident which happened on the 27th of July 2014 in East Turkestan. So it was the 27th of the Ramadan, a holy day for the Uyghurs, and all the men went to mosque to pray, and the women and children were remained in their houses, and a group of women gathered in a home and wanted to pray, but the Chinese security forces considered this action as an illegal religious activity and break into the houses, into this house, and killed 12 people in this house, including 3-year-old child and 70-year-old woman.
Bunu Xitoy hukumatı çıkıp ketkendikin meçitki barlık erle kayıt kilip bu paçayını kökendikin bütün mahallenin adamları kozgulup getirdi.
Now of course when the man informed about the this incident, they came and they of course they protested against this brutality of the Chinese police.
Çünkü bu vaka keşti bolgan vaka bolgaşka seher vakti bilen bütün adamlar ölüklerini götürüp sakçının aldığa hemisi gömürülüp barıdı.
And they took all the bodies of the dead Uyghurs and came to to protest and gathered in front of the police station of the Ilishko County.
Allah kaçan idiye tayarlık koygan Xitay hükümeti etrafını askerler bilen korçap durup sakçılar bilen işçiden optimatıyla itip hatta aş kolu kuçuğudu balısı ve ayarlardın tatıp bağın erlerden tatıp aş nek meydanda sakçı aldığı yığılgan halı kanç olsa şunçını kırıp öldürdü.
So the people wanted just to, you know, peacefully to protest and ask the Chinese government to punish the perpetrators of this, you know, bloody incident. But of course, the Chinese police opened fire and killed hundreds of the Uyghurs, including children and women, in front of the police station.
Etsilan bunu Xinhua'da toplançılarını öldürdük, teröristlerini öldürdük deyip dünya ilan kıldı.
But the Xinhua news agency reported the next day that the Chinese security forces killed the terrorists in the region.
Lekin yani şunun bilan qanaat qilib qolmasdan ertisi ertigende bu vaqa oqshimi bo'lgan bo'lib kechich xalqlar o'ltirilib bo'lgandikin ertisi ertigende tikichar ayroplan bilan u butun yezilar yakanning shu yezisidagi odamlarni dehqonchilik chiqib atgan odamlarni odamsiz tikichar ayroplan bilan qirib tashlaydi mahallami mahalla yurib.
So then Chinese military was also involved. And military helicopters also used in this, operation. And Chinese government, Chinese security forces launched an operation in three villages of the this Ilishko County and killed hundreds of people in these villages, in three villages.
Biz şu vakti de bunu dünyaya haber kısak yalgandaydı.
When we reported this to the international community, there was no response.
Jurnalistler aşkın kuşa nimini bese şunu rastladı aşkların propagandasını.
Unfortunately, the international media also just quoted what the Xinhua reported.
Lakin çetellik yakışı muhbirlerimiz aşı ayrıplanının uçkan aşı mahalli üstüdeki resimlerini tatıp dünyaya çıkarıp etkendiğin kiyin Xitay andıkin ıhra kılıp vay biz muşundak toplançılarını bastırdık ayrıplan bilen de ıhra kılıdı.
But when a few days later, when the international correspondents dare to go to the region and report, then Chinese Xinhua agency also accepted that there was a popular uprising and the Chinese security forces used force to suppress that.
Şunundan bir yıl burun yana Lükçündümü oxşaşlaşdı ayırplan bilen qırğınçılıq qılıdı.
1 year earlier in Lükçün county of Turfan, also Chinese security forces used military helicopters to kill Uyghur farmers in the region.
Hem de Xitay hükümeti hazır dünya terörizm hareketinden faydalanıp Uygurlarını tinçlik bilen özünün erkinlik için kureşkığa Uygurlarını tinçlik bilen bir makal yazgan Uygurlarını tinçlik bilen fikir vergen Uygurlarının hemisini terörist hep kankülemde vatanın içinde bastırıp atıdı vatanın teşirikini tutup ekitip atıdı hemen bütün jurnalistlerle bütün dünyadaki akbarat oranına bu Yaponiya'ya kilip hem Yaponiya halkı, Yaponiya hükümetine muşu işladım bir haberdar kılay deyip geldim.
So Chinese government also of course used a war on terror in order to suppress the peaceful dissidents in East Turkestan. So everybody, Chinese government consider every action, every complaint or every protest as a terrorist action and kill the Uyghur dissidents as terrorists. So I came to Japan and also I want to call the international community to draw attention to the terrible situation in our region.
Muhbir efendimle Uyghurlarının ahvali hazır intayin iğir.
The situation of the Uyghur people, as I said, terrible.
Bir millet cinayetçi de biktildi Xitay hükümeti tarafından.
So all the Uyghurs are being considered as potential suspect by the Chinese.
Hazırki Xi Jinping hükümetinin bütünlüğü yok tutuş objektifi aylandı.
So Xi Jinping government, Xi Jinping government launched a wholesale attack on Uyghurs.
Meselen, Jungo'da, Xitay devleti de hem adamda birden kimlik var. Lakin Uyghurlara alayda ikinci kimlik veriliyor.
So everybody has a one identity card in China, but Chinese government issued two identity cards for the Uyghur people.
Eğer Uyghurlar bir nesli çıkmanda ki şundaklam kartta yelik kartını çıkarıp çıkırgandikin üyede Uyghurlarını tipi vatkan, uru vatkan, harla vatkan, karşılaşı vatkan, muşunda hadiseler çıkıdı.
So sorry, the Chinese government issued a different identity card for the Uyghur people. So they put a chip in that card. When they come to a checkpoint, when they put that scan that identity card, then it will, you know, give a sound and alarm the security forces that he is Uyghurs and he'll be, you know, checked, you know.
Sharqi Turkistan'ın işçi hazır. Muşu tiniş halk yaşavatkan cimcitlik rayılla bütün asker bilen ikinci dünya uruşudaki oh şaşlam kaplap ketken tankı, optimat, iştila bilen jürüvatkan Uyghurlar aşlanın arısta nan aşıyap yaşavatıdım.
So the policy of the Chinese government turn East Turkistan almost to a war zone. There are military vehicles, Chinese soldiers patrolling every street of the Uyghur neighborhoods, Chinese police, armed police everywhere. So almost it looks like a war zone if you go to East Turkistan.
And men işkinilan bir meselini, işki meselini misal kıpadım. Her haftada, her 10 günde Uyghurlar şunda katlı kırgınçılık, şunda tutkun buluvatıdı. Mali mali şehir şehirlerde. Hem şuna bugün sizlerin ki kandak suallarının lavası cevap birey. Bugün sizlerge yetkizdiğin gibi bir şey tamamladı.
So there is, every day there is a bloody incident in East Turkestan. And every day Uyghurs are being killed by the Chinese security forces. So a this situation is deteriorating. So
now I'm back and took him to the and yani bir nese biz bu dünya müracaat qıp hemiyə çıxıbatımız Xitayla Uyğurların öldürüşünü Jungo'nun işki işi deyip dünyanın hiç qasını yaqın keltirməyə batdı.
So Chinese government claim that this all these incidents what's happening is a internal affairs of East of China, so nobody has the right to interfere.
Bu işki iş emas. Bu kadar adam ölüvatkanken dünya arlaşıdığı iş, bu bir kişilik hukuk işi. Şunun için bütün dünyanın bunun arlaşını ümit kılımız.
So number of the people are being killed by the Chinese authorities or killed by the Chinese security forces and number of the Uyghur dissidents people and people who disappear reached to a level that require an international interference.
Ben yalnız Uyghurlarla emas, Şarkı Türkistan'da yaşavatkan her millet halkının tiniş hatırcam yaş üçün yardım kılışanlarına ümit kılmak.
So we would like to create a condition in East Turkistan that all the ethnic groups who live in East Turkistan should live in prosperity and peace. And I would like to ask your support in our movement.
Thank you very much for this introduction. So we go straight to question and answers. I will take working press first, and if there's enough time, I go to other people. As usual, please introduce yourself and keep your question, one question, as short as possible. Who wants to go first? Uchida-san.
My name is Fujita. I'm independent and affiliated with the evening newspaper, Yukon Fuji. I'd like to know exactly what kind of things do you expect to the Japanese government or Japanese media or Japanese people? I would like to, for example, if you have specific requests or proposal, I'd like to know.
dedim o şu Japonya hükümet dedim ya metbuat dedim dedi seninki kandak bir uçuk bir talepin var.
Japonya hükümetinin talebim bizdinki Japonya hem de bizim işimizga nurgun köngül bildiras biz üçün bir dostluk grup kuruldu. 40'tan artık adam ba parlament içindeki dostluk grubumuzda. Lakin hazırgıcı bir emli bir iş kıpıramadı.
As you know, the Japanese politicians have been showing a great interest to the Uyghur issue, and they are very sympathetic to our cause. And a Uyghur-Japan friendship group was created in Japanese Parliament, and it has 45 members now. But we haven't seen real and specific action by this group to raise the awareness about the situation of the Uyghur people.
Biz ümit kılımız Japonya hükümeti Uyghurlarının meselesini taşkı işle ve özünün hükümetinin siyasi tertibine ekirişini ve Uyghurlarının kutkuzuşunu bir kanun makullamdı birini mi kılıp Uyghurlar meselesine Kıtay resmi arlayışını, sohbette oturuğu koyuşunu, vatanımızda tekşiriş ümek ivetip, hak işini nemi buluvatı da tekşirişini ümit kılımız.
And also we would like to Japanese government to raise the Uyghur issue when they met with the Chinese officials. And about they should talk about the human rights violation in the region. And put the Uyghur issue in their agenda when they meet, when they involved in any meetings with the Chinese officials.
İstaşlık bildiriş emas, emilli iş kılışını. Xitay bilen zada bizning tekşiriş ümek ivetiş. Uyghurlarını nim için öldürüvatı sen deyiş. Hem de jurnalistlerden benim koyduğum taleplerim. Jurnalistler, Xitay'nın devamının şıkhaşenin işletken rimi ribavının yalgan propagandalarını emas. Bizning Şarkı Türkistan'a birip bu dünya degen yarışarılışıp kette hazır. Bir hakiki ahvalını körep kilişi, halkının ağzının muşunda anlışı, yığılavatkan tövellerine düşüp dikallarının avazını anlışı, ölüvatkan adamlarının parzentlerini intervi kilişi, a propaganda bile manı seliştirip dünyaya hakiki neresinin kıyafetini açık için ümit kılımız.
And also we would like to ask the Japanese government to send a fact-finding missions to East Turkestan and to find out what's happening, what's really happening on the ground. And we would like to ask the Japanese journalists not to, quote what the Chinese official media report about the incidents in East Turkestan. They should send their own reporters, ask the Chinese government to let their reporters to report from the region and go to the region and find out the fact and then report about an incident. About the incident, not only quote the Chinese official news agencies like Xinhua and Renminbi.
Hem her kandak vaktida Xitay hükümeti tarafından muhbirler devamlı yığın içirdi. Uyghurlar doğruluk sual cevap verdi. Şu Uyghurlar doğrulukla emas özünün devlet siyasetinin intayı mukum bu ketkeldiği, şunda halkının bekt yaşavatkallığı hakkında deklatlarını verip muhbirler cevap verdi. Şu vaktida Uyghurlar ne için ölüdü, ne için turmak kurdu, ne için oturunlar macera tükümeyi digen suallarını koyuşunu ümit kılıma.
Also we would like the Japanese reporters in Beijing when they on the foreign ministry briefings, for example, they should ask when they talk about a situation in East Turkestan or Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region, they should ask questions contrast to the what the officials claim. They should ask the Chinese officials why all these bloody incidents are happening in East Turkestan. And why are this tension on rising increasingly between the ethnic groups in the region?
Okay.
Yes. Hello, I'm from the BBC. I'd like you to comment on a couple of things. One is the recent bombing in Bangkok in Thailand. The Thai authorities have arrested a number of people who they say are of Uyghur background, and also on the rising number of incidents of violence we've seen against Han Chinese targets inside Xinjiang, inside East Turkestan, if you like, and also in other parts of China, the Kunming railway attack in which many people were killed. These, again, have been blamed on Uyghur terrorist groups by the Chinese government. So I'd like you to address those issues. And also, is the Chinese government claims it is now facing an international terrorist problem within its own borders. Can you respond to that?
Bu terörist grup mesela bir terörist grup Kunming de bunda kıldı deydi. Ondaki Hıhtay hükümeti hazır bu Uygurların halkara terör nimelleri de. Münasebeti var şunda halkara terör hareketi bilen karşı karşı mendep davet ediyor deydi. Hoşunan bu oğlan sizinki cevabını.
Aldı bilen Tayland'daki parlatış vakası meyli Kunming olsun. Bunda günahsız adamlarını öldürüp zoravallık kılışını dünya Uygur kurtu biz Uygur halkı katık ayıplayımız.
So the World Uyghur Congress and the Uyghur people condemned, you know, the bombing in Bangkok, and we condemn all kind of violence, and we don't want to see innocent people being killed.
Biz bundaq buluşni bizning Uyghur xalqi umid qilmaydi, xolimaydi dedi.
The Uyghur people is against all kind of violence and condemn all kind of terror actions.
Çünkü Xitayning uzun yillardan beri maqsadi Uyghurlarni mushunga bog'lab, butun dunyoga Uyghurlarni ashunda tashviq qilish orqali yo'qotmoqchi.
Because Chinese government has been trying very hard since many years to link the Uyghur movements, the Uyghurs to the international terror groups and find a excuse to crack down further on Uyghurs.
Biz Xitay hükümeti bilen birine çıkıttım bütün dünyaya 10 yıldan beri devletimiz ben turmadan çıkılı 10 yıl oldu. Muş Uygurların her günü öldürüş, tutuş, iktisadi cayettim, veyran kılış, kızlarını ekiliş, muşunda kötü egil olmaydıgan pacı erlik bastırış, Uygurların katı kollukka, zoravallık iştirip kalmışsın Xitay hükümeti muşun toktasında biz 10 yıldan beri bütün dünyaya ve Xitay hükümeti müracaat kıldık.
So I was released 10 years ago from the Chinese prison, as you know. And since I took over the World Uyghur Congress, we have been calling on Chinese government to ease the tension and stop the repression and change its policy in Xinjiang, in East Turkestan, and don't push the Uyghurs to the edge and create a situation and to radicalize the Uyghurs and to push the Uyghurs to the situation to a degree that then there will be violence.
Xitay hükümetigimi biz şundaq dep keldik.
And also we ask the Chinese government to stop its repression, because the repression will lead then to the violence and create the situation now we face now in East Turkestan.
Lekin Xitay hükümeti onu mu dedi? Bunun dini 20 yıl burun. Xitaylar özümü de baksın, Şarkı Türkistan'a bağlan Xitay halkımı de baksın. Bir Uyghur koluğu şunda bir nersi elip, bir nersi partlıgan mı? Ya ki bir Xitay'a karşı çıkan mı desin, onda kişiler bop bakan emez.
You can ask also Chinese people, you know, 20 years ago there was no violence. There was, we haven't seen any news, any information that a Uyghur stabbed a Han Chinese or killed a Han Chinese. And there was a bloody incident between the two ethnic groups.
And the Uyghurlar şu vaxt idim namrat, şu vaxt idim Uyghurlar harlık astıda, besim astıda, zoravallık astıda boğan bosumu, hazırkıgı nispeten biraz yakşıraktı.
So at the time, 20 years ago, also the Uyghurs were under the Chinese government's repression. But the repression was not so intense as it is today.
Dünya 9/11 vakası çıkan gündün tatıp Xitay hükümeti Uyghur'unu excuse me deyip öldürdüğün paytım geldi. Çünkü bu İslam dini itikad kagallığı için bütün Uyghur'unu terörizmle bağlayıp yoktuğun buldum deyip Uyghurlarını aş bir isim bilerle hücum kılıp bakadın baka tutkun kılış öldürüşünü başlayıp etti.
So, but the, after the 9/11, Chinese government thought that it has now an opportunity and used a pretext the war on terror to crack down on Uyghurs and call all actions of the Uyghur people as terror actions and use 9/11 as a pretext to suppress the Uyghur dissent.
Nurgullugan gunasız, hiç kandak hişimini bilmeydigan, hatta özü turmugi kirip, nimigi kirgini bilmeydigan yaşla minglap minglap turmulagı toşup ketti.
So there are now thousands of Uyghur political prisoners. Many of them don't know why they are in prison.
Men özemmi turmudi yetip, dastlabdi nimigi kirmay qalganım, nimigi kirip qalganımni bilmedim.
I also spent more than 6 years in Chinese prison. I even didn't know at the beginning why I'm in prison, why they arrested me and put in jail.
And the Kunming vakası cevap verme.
So I want to say a few words about the Kunming incident.
8 minute içinde.
8 minute mi? Cihrak mı?
8 minute şu an ilan. 8-9 minute içinde 30 neçe adam öldürülüp çünkü 100'dün artık adam yardar boğallığını ilan kıldı dedi.
So Chinese government, of course, in Kunming incident, Chinese government claim that within a few minutes, 8 people killed 32 innocent people and injured more than 140 people in a train station in Kunming.
Poiz stansi, putillay khanzu khalqi ve sakhchila bilen kaplangaya.
So, if you go to Kunming, you will find out that the train station is full with the security personnel and also with the Han people.
Şedemle açıkıp hiç kandak adamga aşkarlımaylam muşu men kıldım dedi dep itip etti.
So Chinese government claim that they arrested some people and without letting them to speak to the international media or to any person, they claim that they accepted their that they carried out this attack and executed 3 of them.
Bütün Uyghur halkının fikrini men aqlab atmayma, bütün Uyghur halkının ve haqiqatni biladigan Xitoy halkının mı bu mesele üstüde gumanı var? Bu Xitoy hükümetinin alaydı terbiyelengen etirtinin qığa işi. Çünkü Xitoy hükümetinin siyasi işki cahettin çirip ketken boğallığı için muşundak vaqa çıkırış arkalık özünün adımını korkutup Uyghurlarga atıp durup Uyghurlarını mı bastırmakçı, Xitoylarının ağzını basmakçı diken geple taklif atıdı. Men bu ras mı, yalgan mı, ras Uyghur kıldı mı? Ya ki aşındak bir vaka buldu mu? Bunu ben toluk cevap veremeyim.
But of course, we don't know who carried out this Kunming terrorist attack. But many claim that it is related with the internal, domestic conflict within the Chinese leadership. Also has some thing to do with the Chinese conflict among the Chinese leaders. So they claim that they are Uyghurs, so the Uyghurs carried out this attack, but we don't know who was behind this and is behind this, terrorist attack. So it is very suspicious, incident. So we have been also trying to find out the fact.
Kandak adamdan kılıçtın kat'i nazar bunu kıran vahşi adamını biz kattık ayıplayımız bunda kışının buluşunu kalmayımız.
But of course we condemn the Kunming attack and as a terrorist attack and we condemn this action because we don't want anywhere to see innocent people are being killed.
Thank you.
Okay, next question, please. Yes, please.
Elaine Lees, Reuters. So you mentioned that due to the Chinese repression, that tensions are rising in Xinjiang. Are Uyghurs in Xinjiang becoming increasingly radicalized? And why? Is this a reaction to China's controls, and what could this lead to?
Biz mu şunundan endişkıvatımız değildi. Çünkü Xitay hükümeti Uyghurlarının dini erkilliğinin, normal kitabatkan dini erkilliğinin hemisini besiş ve onun din çekleş, bir kadın normal dini erkillik ve adamların turmuna ekilip taşlaş, ölüm cezası hüküm kılış, müddetsiz müddetli kamak cezası ilan kılış arkalık 20 yıldan beri na etti Uyghur halkılığa kattık bir bastırış hep badi.
So the Chinese government's religious repression, especially religious repression, became unbearable in East Turkestan. The people cannot practice their daily religious activities as well. Normal religious activities even. So this unbearable religious repression, of course, lead to a radicalization of the Uyghur people.
Yeah, onun bilan radikallashib ketdi deb aytmayman. Ashindaq bastirish orqali turmug'i tashlash, bikadin bikaga dini arboblarni o'lim jazosi hech qanday sababsizlar bir o'quvchini o'qitibsan deb bir dini taqvodor bir arboblarni akriblan o'lim jazosi qato ochiq o'lim jazosi hukm qilish, shuning bilan bularning hammasini turmug'i tashlash, onundan keyin bularni ruz tutmaysan, namoz o'qimaysan, uni qilmaysan deb agandikin xalq bilan Xitoy hukumatı o'tirda bir qarishlish paydo bo'lib, xalqni oshinda har xil narsaga bosh urishga sabab chiqildi.
So especially the Chinese government repression, religious repression, so created a tension, rising the tension between the Chinese government and Uyghur people. Because Chinese government interfere in daily practice of the religious practice of the Uyghur people, they arrest without any reason the Uyghurs who pray at the homes and consider praying at home as illegal religious activities. And people who teach the Uyghur children in private schools are being arrested and sentenced to a long time imprisonment, even executed. And also Chinese government, especially during the Ramadan, banned Uyghurs to practice the Ramadan and observe the Ramadan. And even they came to schools and classes and forced the students in classes and teachers to drink, to eat in front of Chinese officials to make sure that they are not observing the Ramadan. So this situation created a terrible tension between the government and between the Uyghur people.
Xalq bilan hukumat o'tirda qattiq bir qarshilishish paydo qildi deydi.
This conflict. Yeah. Okay.
Shu qarshilishish jarayonida xalqning nemiga bosh urishini uqmay, har xil narsalarga bosh urudigan ahvolni hukumatning siyosati keltirib chiqadi.
So this policy of the Chinese government created a situation that the Uyghurs joined other groups.
Shunga biz Xitoy hukumatiga bu siyosatni o'zgartirish, Uyg'urlarga bir chiroyli muomala qilish, bunday odamlarning yetilib chiqilishi, mana shunda qarshilishning paydo bo'lishining oldini olish to'g'riliq bir necha qitim taklif berdik va Amerikaga dedik, boshqa davlatlarga dedik, shu ishning oldini olish to'g'riliq. Lekin Xitoy hukumatı kundan kunga Uyg'urlarni besishni ig'irlashtirdiki, yeniklashtirmadi. Shu sababdan 10 minglagan Uyg'ur Tailand, Malayziya, Turkiya qatarliq yerlarga qochdi. Mana hech nimani bilmaydigan Uyg'urlar dunyoning hamma yerida hozir tarqab ashnaq yuribotdi.
And of course we asked the Chinese government to change its policy because we were worried that this Chinese repression will lead the situation we are facing now. And we also ask other Western government even to put pressure on Chinese government to change its policies because we knew that this policy, this repression will lead the situation we face now. Now thousands of Uyghurs fled the country and escaped from China, took refuge to the neighboring countries, to Thailand, Malaysia, Turkey, and now we can find Uyghur refugees all over the world.
And the Xitoy hukumatı o'zingizlar ko'rdinglar, ashq kechib chiqqan sargandar bicharlarni Tailand turmisidan 115 odamni aketdi. Pul berib.
As you know, the Chinese government put pressure on Thai officials to return 115 Uyghurs forcibly back to China.
Ularning 3-dan 2-dan ballarini, xotinlarini Turkiyaga berib, erlarini, yosh qiran erlarining hammasini aketdi. Hozirgacha urib o'ltadimi yoki qiynab o'tadimi bizning xabarimiz yo'q.
So the Chinese officials, of course, put pressure on Thai to return these Uyghur refugees. And the interesting thing is that their children and their wives were sent to Turkey. And their husbands sent back to China. So we don't know what happened all these 115 people who were deported back to China, whether they are being killed or it is very obvious they have been tortured. We don't know what happened,
whereabouts of these.
So of course the Uyghurs now in, live in foreign countries, know what's happening in the world. But the Uyghurs inside East Turkestan and is unaware of the situation in the foreign countries.
Radio anlaş, internette çetelerin uçturuşunu mındak bir nimillerini görüş. Aşında tutuva gandikili o Uyghur 10 yıl kesilip gitti. Hiç kaysının çetelerde bir hazırki terakiyatın haberi yok. Uyghur'un beşi hazır kop kuruklam çetelge çıkan Uyghurlar işimini okumaydı. Kim nege yutulup kesin şu hareket edildi.
So Uyghurs are live in a, of course, in a very closed society, and the Chinese government doesn't allow the Uyghurs to communicate with the outside world. And if they they can, they don't have you know, access to international media, they don't have access to free press, because if they listen to the foreign radio stations, if they caught listening to the foreign radio station, they'll be punished severely. Even there are people who sentenced to 10, 12 years only for listening to foreign radio stations. So therefore, Uyghurs are unaware what's happening in the outside world. And when they come out of the country, when once they are in out in a foreign country, they don't know the people who the people who are leading them, where they are going, where they are staying.
Aslı bizden aşı Uyghurlar ilk çıkka vaxtı da işkicil Tayland sergendar objudu Malayca bilen. Dünyaya biz bağdı, güvengi bağdık, Amerika'yı bağdık, Türkiye'yi cügedik. İşkicil gıçı bizden cügümüge yerimiz kamıdı. Dünya aşı sergendarlar ilk çıkış gerek. Ula ya İngiliz çıtıl bilmeydi, ya Arap çıtıl bilmeydi, ya Pakistan çıtıl bilmeydi. Uyghur tılıdan başka hiç neresini bilmeydi. Ula şundak hadiselerle uçuruştun biz mu ve bütün Uyghurlar hazır. Endiş işçi de dedi.
So they when the Uyghur refugees came to the Thailand and detained by the Thai authorities, we asked the United Nations and other Western countries to interfere to, you know, to so find a solution for the people who are in detention in Thailand. But nobody, you know, took a serious actions to solve this problem. They remain in Thai prison, Thai detention center for months, more than 1 year, and they in a very dire situation and dire conditions for almost 2 years.
Anandikin mushu aslında beş kuruk oğandı kaysa adam başlası şu taraf kikitudu. Pekat bir Türkiye alam, andikin ekettikin kagallarını
deyledim. So only the Turkish government was ready and willing to take some of the refugees.
Bundan
and Uyghurs, Uyghurs, another thing is Uyghurs cannot speak the language, which except Uyghurs, they are not, they cannot speak Arabic, they cannot speak Persian, English. They cannot speak English. So some, of course, of the, so this situation lead to some Uyghurs to join some groups maybe, yeah.
Next question. Maybe I had a question here. You asked several times for Western countries, but also Japan, to intervene in the favor of Uyghurs, to make pressure on the Chinese government. How realistic do you think this is? After all, China is a major trading partner of almost any Western country, including Japan also. It's politically very important. How realistic is it that these countries stand up for the Uyghurs?
Dedikem de siz bayatın açık etimi tekrarladınız dedim. Oşa garip devletleri, oşa Japonya'dan biz bu işe arlaşsın deyip talep kılımız mı Uyghur işe deyip de. Bunun ki kançılık, riyallık bulalıydı. Mesela Hıhtay hükümeti şunda kudretlik. Hem deydi hem oşa garip devletleri, hem oşa Japonya mı deydi. Bunun ki iktisadi münasebetlerine ait kem bu Hıhtay bileliydi. Muşunu közlüğe tutkan çağda kançılık bir reallık bulalaydımış o bu devletlerin kişilerin çınlığı arlaşıydı.
Mesela Tibet meselesi, Tibet'in Hıhtay hükümeti hazırgıçı, nurgun milli kimliği ve ulanı bastırış. Tibet mi bizgi okşaşla nurgun azap okubetini 60 yıldan beri okşaş takip kebatımızdaydı.
So as you know, the Tibetans, our situation is very similar to Tibet situation. Tibetans also have been suffering under the Chinese rule for the 60 years.
And Tibet mu aşındak azap okubetler paylama özünün ki üstüdü ki besim ve milli kimlik milli horluk çıdımay özünü ot köydür valdı kancılığa adam.
So there is also the Chinese government also threatened the Tibetans culture and national identity. Because of the repression in Tibet, as you know, there is this immolations, more than 100 people, you know.
Lekin bütün dünya Tibet doğruluk sözlügen boğallık için Tibet'nin ışığı bütün dünya, garip dünyası katık arlaşkan ve Japonya'dan tadı katık arlaşkanlık için Xitay hükümeti bizni kırganda kırvetemedi deyledi.
So, but the Tibet issue is very well known in international community and many Western countries and the US and also maybe Japan, you know, interfered and raised the Tibetan issue and speak on behalf of Tibetans in many international forums and talk with the Chinese government also about the Tibet issue. Therefore, Chinese government is more careful in implementing its repressive policies in Tibet in comparison to the East Turkestan or Uyghurs.
Tibet'te mi turmaladı şundak siyasi mahpuslarca ulanım öldürüvatıdı. Lekin bizde mundak her ay işçide 10'dun, 20'dun, 30'dun kandak öldürüvatıdı. Uruşlu ölgendek ölüvatıdı bizden adam.
Of course there are, in Tibet also there are a lot of, you know, hundreds of, maybe thousands of political Tibetan political prisoners. But the level of the repression, level of the, you know, this killings on, or is not you cannot compare with what's happening in East Turkestan.
Şuna dünyanın arlaşkınlığa ula arlaşkandı kim bizim meselemiz bunda öltege baktı da dünyanın arlaşkınlığı ünümü buludu. Xitay çoğup gitti dese bu kişilik hukuk meselesi de dünya yoğunap gitti de bu yalnız bizim tınışlıkımız emez. Bütün Asya'nın tınışlıkı bozuldu bu işte. Meselen Uygurla kaçıp çıktı bana. Cim vatende turvatkan Uygur kaçıp çıkmakan bolsa muş Tayland iş bulmaydı dedi dedem. Bana dünyanın tınışlığı buzuldu degen gap degen gap.
So that shows that the intervention of the Western governments, you know, Western world is effective, you know, in case of Tibet, we can, you know, it is an example. If we, of course, if we don't interfere, they don't involve in any issue regarding the Uyghurs, then the situation will get terrible. And because it is now a security issue also. If
the Uyghurs,
if there was not repression, the Uyghurs would not escape to the Thailand, and this bombings in Thailand would not happen.
Bunda iş mi bulmaydı dedin? Bana demek bu yalnız Uyghurların tanışlığı emez. Bütün dünyanın tanışlığı, bu dünyanın arlaşılığı işi şunun için dünya bu Xitay'ın gapını anlamdı, anlamamdı, Xitay'a gap kılış gerek dedim.
But the Uyghur issue now is becoming not only a Chinese issue, it is becoming an international issue. So therefore, the Western governments should, you know, interfere, should, you know, start a new approach to the Uyghurs and raise this Uyghur issue with the Chinese government in order to ease the tension and create a situation that people can live in peace in East Turkestan.
Okay. Yeah. If you don't have any, just say, there's nobody else, so please go ahead again. Yeah.
President Xi Jinping is about to go to the UK for a state visit, and he's going to be welcomed by the Queen of England. He's going to be given the red carpet treatment. The British government says it will not talk publicly about human rights, that it's better to talk privately. The finance minister of the UK, on a recent trip to China, went to Xinjiang, went to Urumqi, seemed to do a lot for Chinese propaganda by doing so. What do you say to the British government and its policy towards China on the Uyghur issue and on the issue of human rights? How should they do it differently?
Angeliya Maliksi bunun qayana qızıl gilam qoyub nayda oni dərəcədə bunu kutub aladı kəmdi dedi. Kutub aladı dedi. Onun dikinizə ma bu nima? Angeliyaninki maliya ministri yaqında Şinjanğı mı ziyarətdə bubdu. Bu yer bolğandiki deydi o Xitay üçün bir nayd çox təşviqat bub bədi deydi uninki bağını deydi. Amma muşundaq bir vəziyyətdə bu angeliyaninki bu nimisiga qandaq qaraysız, nima deysiz deydi.
Angliya amaldarlarga Xitoy hukumatı avtomat bilan Uyghur qizlarini jigitlarini ochib soyinatib berdi deydi. Avalmışında. Dağ deydigan gapman.
Nah. So of course for the foreign officials including the financial minister of the UK who visits, you know, Xinjiang, the Chinese government will bring the Uyghur girls, dancers, who, to show that Uyghur people are, you know, so happy and full of prosperity in Xinjiang, and people are living in harmony.
So they
will not see the dark side of the, you know, situation in the region, and will come back with the impression that the people are living in peace in East Turkestan.
Lekin Angliya hukumatı bilemdi desa, bizning hozir qirg'inchilik uchrab atganimizni biludi. Albatta, oshindaq bog'a vaqtlarda bu xalq bunda qilmasligi kerak deb o'tirg'i qo'yib, Uyg'urlar masalasiga tinchlik bilan muomala qil, bular yaxshi muomala qilsin, uni anglamaydi emas Xitoyga. Bu gap ta'sir qiladi deydi-da.
So of course the UK government is aware, very much aware what's happening in East Turkestan about the Chinese, ongoing Chinese crackdown. Of course, if the they should tell the Chinese president that, you know, that he should change his policy in East Turkestan and, you know, and respect the human rights, at least the human rights of the Uyghur people.
Xitoy hukumatı bütün dünyanın ağzına aş pulunu tıkıp kızıl gilemlerinin ders üstüge. Aşı kızıl gilemler silingan tıkkan pulda bizden kaynımız var. Tibet'nin, Uyghur'nun, Mongol'nun, aş ölüp atkan Xitay'daki günahsız adamlarının kıyını var.
So of course it is very unfortunate that they are welcoming the President Xi White by the red carpets. So they should know that in that red carpets there are bloods of the Uyghur people, Tibetan and other Chinese dissidents.
Şunun için biz Angliya hükümeti bir demokratiya devlet. Angliya hükümetinin mu Xitay'a her kandak iktisadi meselini birinci koyga vakt iktisadi meselini koyganda kişilik hukuk meselesini ve Uygurların aşında izli vatkan milletlerinin ahu zarı meselesini anlayışını ümit kılımız. Çünkü bütün dünyada, bütün dünyanın aynı vakta hocayını olan bir devlet hazır Xitay'ın ki bizden emir kuvatkallığını ula bilmeyi kanmaydı. Oturuğu koyuş gerek. Hem de hayran kuvatı ben dünyanın hem yeri Xitay pul götürüp verip vatanın özünün içinde bunda kan tökülüp atıdı, dünyanın hemen yerde teştirip atıdı. Ben bugün Japonya'ya iltimas kıl geldim bu gaplarımı demem. Japonya hükümetinin mu ve şununla birge Angliya, bosa Angliya hükümetinin mu Uyghur meselesini devamlı oturup koyuşunu, bütün dünyanın oturup koyuşunu ümit kılma. Bulup mu Japonya Asya'daki bir kudretlik demokratiya devlet?
Okay. Of course we want the, you know, the governments and states should have good relation with China, good economic relation with China. But they should use that economic, that good relation with China to raise the human rights issues like the situation in East Turkestan, situation in Tibet, and other issues related to human rights. And to use this, this as an opportunity to raise these issues. And now, of course, we came to the Japan to ask the Japanese government to involve in our issue. So we consider the Japanese Japan as a very powerful democracy in Asia, and we hope, we wish that the Japanese government take actions and to, you know, to make the Uyghur issue as a part of its foreign policy and in its relation with China to raise this issue when they met with the Chinese officials.
Good, we have time for one last question. Well, in that case, I ask it. if you could remind us just what is the Uyghur World Congress asking for? Are you asking for independence? Are you asking for autonomy? Or are you simply asking for respect of human rights?
Dedikem de Uyghur dünya Uyghur kurultayını ki zaten maksadı ne dedi? Mustakillik mi ya öz takdirini özü belgeleş mi ya fakatla kişilik hukuk meselesi mi?
Hazır biz bütün Uyghurlarının özününki, özünün arzusu var, özünün talpı var. Biz hazır pekatlam Uyghurlarının nöyettiki kişilik hukuk meselesini hal kılamız.
So of course the Uyghur people have their own, of course, wish and demand. But now what we are working is to raise the awareness about the human rights situation in our region.
Lekin Uyghur halkı çokum kelgüsü öz tağdırını öz belgeleş gerek değil.
But we hope that the Uyghur people, we think that Uyghur people should determine, you know, at the end, determine their own political future.
So that was a short one, so we have time for another one. Anybody wants to go for last question? Well, if not, then...
So I just wanted to continue, Ms. Kadeer.
I'm sorry, please.
And the Uyghurlar, mushu dünyanın hem yeridin, hem panalık soruduk, hem özümüzge yardım sorap 10 yıldan beri mevatımız, biz tek yakın 10 yıl içinde avazımızın dünyaya anlatıldık.
So as you know, the Uyghurs were not able to leave the country. And therefore, they couldn't, you know, make aware the international community about their situation. We started recently, of course, we started 10 years ago. And in 10 year period, we managed to at least to raise the Uyghur awareness in part of the world.
Ben turmudan çıkkanda bütün dünya, men vaqırsamlam Uyghur yardım kurtadığa okşayıp deyip oylaptım dedi.
So when I was in, of course, in prison, and when I released from the prison, you know, at the very initial period of the my release from Chinese prison, I thought if I raise this issue, if I tell the world what's happening in my country, all the world will rise up and help me.
Мен şu вакытта турмадан чыгыштым бурун биздин ахвалыбызды дүйнө укмайды, уккудуган болсо уйгурлар бундай күн көрмөйдү. Мен чукум уктурма деп чепип чыгыптым. Мен балдарымды ташлап, эмминемди мүлкүмдү ташлап дейди.
When I was in prison, I thought that the world doesn't know what's happening in my country. If the world become aware what's happening there, then they will not stay idle. Inside, they will, you know, take action. They will help me to, you know, to.
Yardım kuvvetidir. Yardım kuvvetmaydı. Mesela Garip devletleri, Türkiye devleti, Japonya, Katarlık devletler. Mesela Türkiye köşmelerimizde nurgun, onmunglagan köşmelerimizde şunda katkı ahval aslında aldı. Amerika her kitim Xitay bilen boğan sohbeti de Uyghur meselesine koyuvadı. Avrupa parlamenti, Cenevemi koldan kilişti. Yardım kuvvetidir. Onda onay emesken deydi de.
Of course, there is sympathy, some support from the Western world, Western countries, especially the U.S. government, raise constantly the Uyghur issue when the U.S. officials meet with the Chinese officials, when even with very high level within president, U.S. president even raise the issue, Uyghur issue, when they met with the Chinese presidents. And also Turkey, for example, in recent years were very supportive, and the Turkish government accepted thousands of Uyghur refugees so to be resettled in Turkey.
Aldı. Japonya mı bizden durgun okuyucularımızın okutup bize yardım kıldı.
And also the Japanese government were you know, very supportive of the Uyghur students, especially there are thousands of Uyghur students who came here and studied in Japanese universities and schools.
Hazır Uyghur halkı intayin igir tasavvur qıp berişki bolmaydigan bir igir ahval astıda aytdı.
But now the Uyghur people are in a situation, in an unbearable situation.
Xizmet köşmen Xitaylarda 10 millionlap ap çıqıp atdı Şinjan Uyghur Aptonom rayon dege atalmış Aptonom rayonga.
The demographic of the East Turkestan already has changed, and Chinese government already transferred millions of Han Chinese from mainland China to East Turkestan.
Sharqi Turkistanning ekologiyasi butunlay buzilib ketdi.
So ecology is already destroyed.
Uyghurlarning o'z ona tili cheklanib, butun ma'rifatdan qoqlab chiqarildi.
the Uyghur language has been banned as language of instruction at school and universities.
Uyghurlarning 2006 yildan boshlab 14 yoshdan 25 yoshgacha to'y qilmagan qizlarimiz majbur Xitoy o'lkalariga o'tkab ketildi. Minglacha.
And since 2006, Chinese government implemented a new policy of transferring young Uyghur women and girls from East Turkestan, especially from southern part of East Turkestan, to mainland China.
Kızlarını Bermigellerini milli bölgüncü deyip turmağa taşladı.
And the people, the parents who opposed this policy and resisted the Chinese authorities to take their daughters, they were accused by the Chinese government as terrorists and put in jail.
2007 yılı bir yıl içinde 24,000 Cenab-ı Şincan'dan kızını ekitip galibi kıldık deyip ilan kıldı. Özünün web sitesinde.
In 2007, Chinese government announced that they transferred 24,000 Uyghur girls from East Turkestan to mainland China, and they said they succeeded in their policy of transferring Uyghur girls to
mainland China. Özününki website de ba.
So it is a official, you know, news official.
Şunundan tatıp her jili vazip kılıp Şarkı Türkistan'dan kızlarını yetkep gitip barıdı.
Since then, you know, the Chinese government constantly transferred thousands of young Uyghur women and girls from
mainland China.
The excuse of the Chinese government is to that they are providing jobs for the Uyghur girls and women.
Million Xitaylar kelip Sharq Turkistan'da ishlaydi. Bizning qizlarimiz nimish Xitoy o'lkasiga qarab ishqorlashtiriladi.
So it is a lie, Ms. Kadeer says, because if they want to provide them job, they can provide them job in East Turkestan, because Chinese government every year transfer millions of Han Chinese from mainland China and providing job, housing and everything.
And the Uyghurlar, yer asti baylığımız, yer üstü baylığımız, bizning cheksiz şundaq baylıq toşqan bir zimin şundaq güzel. Şununga nipit içip, birer kuduk içip, ya kömürkan iç, hukuku yok, bütünlay Xitay köşmelerinin şu hukuku var. Bay buluş qorxsat qılınmaydı.
As you know, East Turkestan is a very rich country. It has a very natural resources like oil, gas, and all kind of rare minerals. And even the Uyghurs doesn't have the right to work in the oil and gas industry, which is very high income industries. They bring workers for that industries from mainland China.
Uyghurlar 86% dihan.
As you know, the Uyghurs are 86% of the Uyghurs are farmers.
Bütün dihanların yeri, munbet suları Xitaylarning bin tuandaydigan bir askerlarga tatib epirildi. Uyghurlar hemsi ezan kulu atıdı.
There is another entity, semi-military entity in East Turkestan, in Xinjiang, which calls the construction army, Xinjiang Construction Army. So it is a semi-military entity. So the land of fruitful lands of the Uyghur farmers confiscated by the Chinese authorities, given to the, you know, to this entity, and they own all these, you know.
Yüzlep adam yerimni bikağı tatıp aldı da Beijing'e az kıkkes kol kaldı.
So hundreds of Uyghurs couldn't went to Beijing to give petition to the Chinese authorities that their land was illegally confiscated by the local authorities, but they were beaten, arrested and sent back to Xinjiang.
And the Uyghurlar nimiş kıldı?
And farmers who lose their houses, lands, they came to the cities, and from cities, some of them went to mainland China. So what the Uyghurs should do? So the people who protested, the people who speak up against these Chinese government's policy was accused by the Chinese authorities as terrorists, as separatists, and put in jail. So what should the Uyghurs do?
Men bir ailemle depreme. Men 6 yıl turmada yattım.
So every Uyghur family is suffering. I can give an example, my family as an example. So I spent more than 6 years in prison.
Yoldaşım 10 yıl turmada yattı okuduk şey.
My husband spent 10 years in prison.
Bir balam 12 yıl yattı.
One of my son spent 12 years in prison.
Yani bir balam 7 yıl yattı.
My other son spent 7 years in prison.
Yoldaşımın dadısı turmudu 3 yıl yetip öldü.
My father-in-law spent 3 years in prison and died in prison.
Hiç kanda iş kılmadık biz. Hatalık ötkezmedik hiç.
We didn't do anything against the Chinese government. We didn't do anything illegal.
Biz bir aile 37 yıl turmudu yattık.
So from one family we spent 37 years in prison.
Ömer'in dadısı 10 yıl yetip çıktı.
Omar, my name is Omar. So Omar's father spent 10 years.
Doktor, adetki bir doktor. Bütün Uyghur ailesi yani aşındak gün körü alatıdı. Uyghurlar kandak kılıdı.
So every single Uyghur family has someone in prison or someone who spent many years in prison. So
Muşu hazır üç alımız deyip çıkıp ketkenler nemişka. Hemisi turmuda, turmuda tutulup kıynal kalla. Aş turmuda kıynap, nait, kattık, azaplı kalla. Aş turmuda keçip çıkıp, aşındaktı, terep terep keçip çıkettı hazır.
Till people who, some of the offer, people who resort to violence, or the people who are parents, who are fathers, brothers, or sisters are suffering in Chinese prison, or who are themselves, who themselves spend many years in Chinese prison, so they resort to violence, some of the people, only to, you know, take revenge from the Chinese government. Yeah.
Okay, thank you very, very much for...
You're welcome.
Yes, thank you. And as it is our custom, we have a one-year honorary membership for Mr. Rebiya Kadeer. Please come back again. Thank you, everybody, for coming.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay, muşka bulduk.